line left on that question, he could have gone a long way. But anyway, filling Toby's seat right now is Matt Marcotte from New York City. Welcome, Matt. Nice to have you here. Looking at these faces brings back so many memories of the nights they were here. Anyway, here's the next fastest finger question. Here it comes. Put these men in order by the country they led, starting at the Atlantic Ocean and going east. Adolf Hitler, Emperor Hirohito, Winston Churchill, Joseph Stalin. Okay, everybody's ready. Let's see the answer in the correct order, starting at the Atlantic Ocean and going east. Winston Churchill, and then Hitler, Joseph Stalin, and Emperor Hirohito. Let's see who got it right of the fastest time. The winner is Al Schaeffer.
Yeah, baby.
Al Schaeffer. Hey, Al, good to see you again. Ready to go for it? We'll be right back with Al.
I know you told me the other night to go with my gut. My gut's telling me something, but I need to use my lifeline.
Let's narrow it down by two. Computer, take away two of the wrong answers, please, for Al. Crosby, Sinatra.
I will go with Old Blue Eyes, Frank Sinatra. The answer is B.
He says it's Frank Sinatra. He's right, it's Frank Sinatra. Yes, Al Schaeffer, North Potomac, Maryland. That's what it looked like last March on our show. And then you went on, you took a look at the $500,000 question.
Right.
Which you didn't want to try.
No, I passed on it, but then you had me guess it, and of course I guessed it right.
Yeah, Catcher in the Rye, something like that?
Right.
Yeah. And your wife is back, Amy, nice to see you again.
Nice to see you.
So Al, did you buy yourself the Harley, the new Harley you wanted after you left us?
Oh, well, no, I've been sort of busy, but we paid a lot of bills. In the process of buying a big play set for my daughter, one of those big swing sets that, you know, it's pretty pricey. So
this is what happened to Al Schaeffer, huh?
Yeah.
Used to play in a jazz band, tour Pure, rode south. His motorcycle all over. Now he's buying swing sets.
Yeah. Pretty sad comment.
When they ask me what happened to Al Schaeffer, I'll tell them. All right, Al, well, glad you're here. You know about the rules. You know about the lifelines. 50-50, ask the audience. Phone a friend. So if you're ready to play, Al, let's do it. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Start, as always, with the $100 question. According to an old saying, a person who works late into the night is burning the midnight what? Pencil, oil, sun, toast.
Burning the midnight oil.
Yes, midnight oil it is for $100. If you serve someone a knuckle sandwich, what do you give them? A punch, a kiss, a stare, indigestion.
A punch, eh?
Yes, a punch is the right answer. $300, coming up. Which of these is a crustacean commonly found at the bottom of boats? Barrister, barnacle, blimp, barca lounger.
Barnacle, B.
Barnacles, that's what you find down there. $500. Approximately how many fluid ounces are in a standard 355 milliliter soft drink can? 6 ounces? 24 ounces, 12 ounces, 32 ounces.
12 ounces.
Final
answer.
Got it for $500. We're going for $1,000, Al. Here it is. What artificial singing technique does a man use to hit notes above his natural vocal range? Staccato, bravissimo, basso profundo, falsetto.
I'm not going to sing it to you, but it's falsetto.
You're right. Okay, you won $1,000. Okay, Al, you successfully navigated your way through those first five. Now here it comes for $2,000. Check it out. For what NBA team did former presidential candidate Bill Bradley play? Washington Bullets, Philadelphia 76ers, Detroit Pistons, New York Knicks.
Dollar Bill played for the New York Knicks.
Final?
Final.
Yes, Dollar Bill, New York Knicks. Those great teams. $4,000, here it is. On the TV series Seinfeld, Elaine worked at what mail order clothing company? J. Crew, J. Peterman, Spiegel, L.L. Bean.
B, J. Peterman.
Final?
Yes.
Yes, she worked for J. Peterman. You won $4,000. We keep going now. Here it is for $8,000. Pot stickers are another name for what Chinese dish? Dumplings, spring rolls, soup, noodles.
Pretty sure it's A, dumplings.
Want to make it your final?
Yeah.
Dumplings, the right answer for $8,000. All of a sudden, we're going for $16,000. All of his lifelines are with him. The Pimlico Racecourse, home of the Preakness Stakes, is located in what city? Philadelphia, Saratoga, Baltimore, Louisville.
Second leg of the Triple Crown is in Baltimore, C.
Final answer?
Yes.
Yes, it's Baltimore, you're right. 16,000. All of a sudden, we're going for $32,000 right now. What is the name of the King of the Fairies in Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream? Prospero, Titus, Ariel, Oberon.
Didn't do too well in Shakespeare class in high school. I'm gonna ask the audience.
Wanna ask the audience? We can do that, yep. Audience, Al needs your help. On your keypads using A, B, C, or D. Please vote now. Whoa, audience not sure of this Shakespeare either. Well, it's 19% for Prospero. Titus got 30%, he was the leader. Ariel came in second at 27% and Oberon 24%. Still can
looking
narrow
for a
it
little
down.
More positive from you guys.
Al, we still can narrow it down, or we can call
Let's call somebody.
Who do you want to call?
Forrest Reed.
Is Forrest a Shakespeare buff?
I hope so.
All right. AT&T, get a Forrest on the line, please.
Hello?
Hello, Forrest?
Yeah.
Yeah, Regis Philbin here from New York. How you doing?
I'm doing fine, Regis. How are you?
Well, you're on the hotline right now because Al needs some help.
Okay, I'm
all right.
Try.
He's going for $32,000 right now. He'll give you the question, the four answers. One of them's the right answer. Okay, Forrest?
Okay, good.
All right, Al, it's all yours. 30 seconds starting now.
Think Shakespeare. What is the name of the King of the Fairies in Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream? Prospero, Titus, Ariel, Oberon.
D, Oberon.
Oberon, you sure?
Very, not absolutely sure. No 100% guarantees, but I think that's correct.
I won't hold you to it, pal. Oberon?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, good luck.
Thanks.
Old Forrest, huh?
Came through.
What does he do?
He's a fellow attorney of mine at the firm.
Okay, what do you think?
I'm gonna go with him.
You're gonna go with Oberon?
Oberon D. Final answer.
He's right. It's Oberon. $32,000. We got there. When we come back, we're going for $64,000. Al Schaeffer from North Potomac, Maryland, in the hot seat right now, and is playing as all of our champions are for a certain charity. Which one, Al?
Right, it's the oncology department at Children's Hospital in Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm.
Two sons of family friends of ours have had to rely on their services and their support, and they've been great, so I want to try and help them out.
Oh, that's good. That's great. All right, let's get back to work here. You won $32,000. You're five away from a million, Al. You still got one lifeline left, so let's do it. Let's play. Here we go. For $64,000, which of the following symbols appears on the official flags of Turkey, Pakistan, and Tunisia? A hammer, crescent moon, cross, sun.
It's definitely not cross. I'm gonna say crescent moon, B.
Wow, still have a lifeline.
It's okay.
You want the crescent moon, B? Final answer?
Yes.
Got that for $64,000.
Don't do that to me.
four away from a million right now, going for $125,000, and here it is. Who was the first African-American keynote speaker at a Democratic National Convention? Jesse Jackson, Ron Brown, Andrew Young, Barbara Jordan.
I think I know this. I think it's Barbara Jordan. I'm gonna say D, final answer.
Got it right for $125,000. $250,000. He's looking at that right now, and three away from 1 million, and still one lifeline. Here it is for $250,000. Who wrote the poem recited at the funeral in the 1994 film Four Weddings and a Funeral? T.S. Eliot, Elizabeth Bishop, W.H. Auden, Rainer Maria Rilke. Let's do it, Al. Computer, take away two of the wrong ones, leaving one right one and one wrong one. W.H. Auden, Rainer Maria Rilke.
I have absolutely no clue. I've seen the movie, but I have absolutely no clue. So I'm going to stop.
Going to stop and walk away. All right, fine. If you took a guess, Al, what would it be?
C.
And you would have been right.
Again,
Al. Again. Okay, $125,000. Great to see you again, Al, and good luck to you. Well, the stars are not wanted now. Put out everyone. Pack up the moon and dismantle the sun. It's a beautiful poem. And what a beautiful thing Al Schaeffer has done for the Children's National Medical Center in Washington, D.C. Anyway, filling Al's seat right now is Ian Reifowitz from New York City. Welcome, Ian.